Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. After the 1600 watts power supply, today we got another huge package, which is the 300 watts portable power station from Yubao. It's equipped with 72,000 mAh lithium iron phosphate battery, which has a longer life than ordinary lithium battery. It also supports speedy fast charging and has a LED light in the middle. Today, ChargeLab will take it apart to see its internal structure and components. Let's go! The most critical specs info is printed on the front, and some critical features are on the lower right corner. The back of the box is pretty simple, and all specs info are printed on the side. We'll talk about it later. Open the box, it contains the power station itself, adapter, power cord, and a manual. The power cord and adapter are separated, and is pretty like the power adapter for PC. The model of this product is EN300WLPD. The specs info in here is the same as the outer box. It adopts silver gray and the brand name is here. There is a handle at the top. All input and output ports are placed on one side, which includes the DC input, LED light, and light switch. Two DC output ports, two USB-A ports, and a USB-C port are in the middle. The main switch and the AC outlet are at the bottom. Those four rubber pads can fix the power station. The ChargeLab Power ZKT002 shows the USB-C supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCP, QC2, 3, PD3, and PBS protocols. And it also has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and 2 sets of PPS. So it can support up to 65W output. Then switch to the USB-A port. It supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCP, QC2, 3, FCP, SCP, Volk-Warp, PE2.0 protocols. And the other USB-A port is exactly the same, so you can choose any of them. Then let's use the original adapter to charge it, and the maximum input power is about 70W. After the test and brief introduction, we're gonna take it apart. And also use the sponge to remove the decorative plastic on both sides. And then separate the case. We can see the battery protection board, the battery cell is under it, and the USB module is on the left side, while the power inverter module is on the right side. Firstly, let's remove all the screws that fix the protection board. A cooling fan is used to dissipate heat from the power inverter module. Ready power is 2.5 watts, and the size is 70 by 15 mm. Then separate the battery pack, inverter module, and USB-C module. There are 10 MOSFETs in parallel to ensure high current output. Those two resistors are used to detect the output current. We also found that the battery pack is connected to the inverter through the fuse, not the protection board. And no components on the back. There are 12 32700 battery cells in total, which are from WTT, and 6000 mAh for each one. Three cells are connected in parallel to form a group, and four groups are connected in series. Back to the protection board, here are four fuses connected in parallel, 30A for each one. Those MOSFETs are from PSD Semi and adopt TO-252 package, 30V, 3.8 mA. The battery balancing resistors and balancing MOSFETs are on the left, and the protection chip is in the middle from CellWise CW1244. It is a 3 to 4 cells series protection IC which provides voltage, current, open wire, temperature protections, and cell balancing. Next, let's take a look at the USB module. The AC outlet and main switch are next to it. The independent aluminum alloy heatsink is on the back of the LED light. Remove the USB module and LED light. Two inductors on the back are used for the input and output of DC and USB-C respectively. The drive circuit of the LED light is in the upper left corner. The DC socket and USB-C ports are on the front. The synchronous buck boost controller is in the upper right corner. Model is Ingenic IP5389. It integrates multiple charging protocols like Volk, PD, QC, and can replace the traditional protocol IC. It also supports bidirectional buck boost charging and discharging with external MOSFETs, and the maximum charging power can be up to 100 watts. Those four MOSFETs can form the full bridge circuit marked with EEUJ38. And those four MOSFETs are used for switching the DC socket marked with EAUJ34. This larger chip is used for the native of the DC socket and adopts PDFN5060 package. Model is QuantSemi KS6205, 68V, 6mΩ. Those two VBUS switch MOSFETs are connected in series, used for the USB-C board. The voltage regulator chip for the buck boost controller is from Micron. Two solid capacitors are used for input and output filtering, 100 microfarad, 35V. This solid capacitor is used for battery, 100 microfarad, 25V. This SoC IC for dual USB-A ports is from Ingenic, IP6538, which integrates synchronous step-down converter and can support 14 different protocols. Except for dual USB-A ports, it also supports dual USB-C ports, a USB-C and a USB-A port. Those two solid capacitors are used for the input and output filtering of the USB-A port, 100 microfarad, 25V for each. A toroidal core inductor is between them. This MCU is used to control the power station and is from ChipC. It integrates 32-bit M0 core, 32KB flash memory, 12-bit ADC, and 4KB SRAM. The voltage regulator chip for MCU is also from Micron. There are four battery indicator lights here. The operational amplifier can detect the output current of the DC port for overcurrent protection, marked with LM358. The buck LED driver is also from Micron, which integrates MOSFET. Next, let's take a look at the final part, the power inverter module. The upper part is the DC bus inverter and the lower is the AC modulation. The back of the inverter module is covered with a plastic sheet to isolate the battery module. Those heat sinks can dissipate heat. Remove the plastic sheet. The tin circuit on the back can reduce the resistance and withstand high currents. The slot can isolate the high and low voltage sides. Here are two 30A input fuses connected in parallel for input overcurrent protection. Two input filter capacitors are from SGEC, 3300 microfarad, 25V. It also has an MCU for control and AC modulation, but nothing is printed on the chip. Three Avolite optocouplers are used for output feedback. There is a thermistor on the heatsink to detect temperature and is 10 kΩ. Remove the heatsink. The boost MOSFETs are fixed on it, which is from China Resources Micro and adopts TO220 package, 60V, 3.2mΩ. The boost transformer is used to boost the low-frequency AC into high-voltage AC. Two boost rectifiers can form the full bridge, which are MUR1660CT and MUR1660CA respectively, 16A, 600V. And then the rectified DC will be filtered by the capacitor, 82 microfarad, 450 volts. The output DC is modulated by the full bridge circuit composed of four MOSFETs. They are fixed on the heatsink and from Fuxing Semi. There is a vertical PCB. Some driver chips and filter capacitors are soldered on it. Two EG micro drivers are used to drive two upper transistors of the full bridge and adopt SO8 package, 600 volts, 500 kHz. This thermistor is used to detect the temperature of the MOSFETs of full bridge circuit. Here is the AC output filtering circuit. The red film capacitor is 1 microfarad, 630 volts. The blue-white capacitor is from Zonkus. The common mode choke is wound with copper tape, and the safety extra capacitor is from Zonkus, 0.1 microfarad. Well, that's all components of this U-Bow 300 watts power station. It can be divided into three modules inside, which is convenient for assembly and maintenance. We found the battery pack consists of 12 lithium iron phosphate batteries inside. The battery output and inverter input end are soldered with fuses for overcurrent protection. And the all-in-one SoC chip for buck boost control and protocol identification can greatly simplify the circuit. It also integrates ChipC MCU to control the U-Bow 300 watts power station. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. Your support is what keeps us going. See you in the next video. Bye!